Good day, fellow investors. When Mohnish Pabrai speaks, I like to listen. And he recently shared on LinkedIn an interview he gave for the Indian Economic Times. We're going to go through the interview and we're going to give five investing tips that I extracted from the interview that discuss also in deep, explain some things from Mohnish Pabrai. He is one of the greatest value investors out there, so there is a lot to learn from him. The investing tips discussed are concentrated portfolio. Three stocks that he owns make more than 50% of his total portfolio. 700 million under management, 400 million is invested in three stocks. And he buys those, listen carefully, at a price earnings ratio of 1 or less. How can there be a price earnings ratio of 1 in this market? Well, there can be, you just have to wait. And you will learn how to do that, how to find those stocks by the end of this video. Three reasons why investments don't work out, so a very important checklist before investing in anything. Cloning stock investments, also something very important to save a lot of time. Don't think about macro. He has no interest in the US anymore, that changed 5 years ago. Before that he was 90% invested in the US, and then finally take a nap. So let's start with a concentrated portfolio and price earnings ratios of 1. So Pabrai has a concentrated portfolio, yes, but he bought those stocks, Fiat Chrysler, Rain Industries and Suntech Realty, to Indian companies when the price earnings ratios of those companies, what he likes to say, was below 1. Not the current trailing price earnings ratio, but the future potential price earnings ratio on the price he pays. So he's really waiting for bargains to find something that can earn in 1 year what he pays for it. To do that, you have to really look at unfavorable industries, like the car industry in 2012. So he finds there companies that will not go bust and have a high potential to deliver high earnings in the future. For example, in 2012, he was buying Fiat Chrysler. And his average investing price is around 4. And you can see that it was even lower. It was 4, but it was also below 3. So he really doesn't care about those short-term changes in price because he's looking for the long-term. So he paid around 4 to buy Fiat Chrysler. Now the stock is at 17. And on top of that, you should add the Ferrari spin-off, which is close to a market cap like Fiat Chrysler. So there is double the return on this investment for Pabrai. The current earnings per share is 2.21. If we deduct 40% of the 2012 purchase price as the value gotten from Ferrari, we get to a price earnings ratio close to 1. Needless to say, just look at the chart. Fiat Chrysler is now at 17. It was at 25. He sold a little bit around 25. He lowered his position. But he's still way, way ahead and a great investment. Double the gain there. As for finding such stocks, Pabrai tells us how we have to keep our eyes open as such opportunities arise once every few years. To quote, "What I found over a 19-20-year investing history is that these, what I call PE of ones, tend to show up an idea every 2 or 3 years. The last similar opportunity he took advantage of was in Indian real estate in Mumbai. He bought 10% of the company Suntech Realty." And you can see the stock price exploded. It's a 5-bagger in the last 2 years. So amazing opportunity he took advantage of in light of the demonetization crisis that hit India and real estate prices around Mumbai. Now, on the three reasons why investments don't work out for investors, the single biggest reason why investments don't work out for investors is leverage. Leverage is followed by misunderstanding of what a moat is and thinking that the company has it. He has gotten to those conclusions by studying a lot of great investors in the past. So leverage, big leverage, really affects a company in a bad way. Then moat, if there someone thinks there is a moat but there isn't, and then it all boils down to management. If the management is good, if there is quality management, then the company, the business, will have a higher likelihood of succeeding. And then we come to something very, very important. Cloning stock investments, looking for the portfolio crown jewels of other investors. And here he discusses how he doesn't like the auto industry. It is high capex, there are unions, there are consumer tastes, and it's very difficult to invest. But in 2012, he was studying other investors that invested in the auto industry, where their largest position in 2012 was General Motors. And I made a video this week about David Einhorn, you can check it in the card above on YouTube, how his largest position is still General Motors. And that's why perhaps Pabrai is still holding Fiat Chrysler. However, he looked at those colleagues that were invested in General Motors, he looked at the auto industry, and only then he invested in Fiat Chrysler. So he cloned the investment idea from somebody else. This is something we shouldn't be ashamed of doing, and he also is humble to share with us that he found Rain Industries because someone sent him an extremely well-written report. Another Indian stock, no need to mention, it is another five-bagger, and it was also even more than that, more than a 10-bagger just a few months ago. Another tip, don't think about macro. Investors should spend zero time thinking about macro anything. Just completely ignore it because it's hard enough to figure out the future of one business. In almost all cases, micro will trump macro in a major way. I must say I agree with him. However, I also look at valuations, I also look at opportunities, and he also does that because he's also disclosing that he has a large cash position at the moment. So he's also waiting for opportunities, which means buying cheap businesses, not that much looking at the macro environment. Nobody knows when there will be the next recession, what will happen with the economy, what will happen with the trade wars, etc., etc. All we can do is find great, cheap, great businesses that will deliver business returns to our portfolios. And that's what also I am doing. I have still a lot of cash waiting to be deployed in good opportunities. However, finding those opportunities requires lots of research. And he has no interest in the US because the US is becoming harder and harder to invest in. The number of stocks in the US declined from 8,000 20 years ago to less than 3,500. There are more and more analysts following, and it's harder and harder to find investing gems. Up to 5 years ago, Pabrai was invested 80 to 90% in US stocks. Now his only US position is Fiat Chrysler, that isn't even a totally US stock. And then another tip, take an afternoon nap. Pabrai believes you can increase your productivity by taking afternoon naps. I don't need them. I work through the afternoon also from the morning researching stocks, but I think that many people would calm themselves down by simply taking an afternoon nap and saying to yourself, everything can wait, I will work better and harder after the nap. For some it works, see if it works for you and if you're depriving yourself of improved efficiency if you don't take a nap. Even Buffett, he asked Buffett when he was visiting him, he asked him, do you take an afternoon nap and do you have a room? And Buffett said, yes, Buffett has an afternoon nap room in his office. On the research that I'm doing now, I'm currently looking at the complete list of Chinese stocks traded in the United States. So you can expect a lot of videos about Chinese stocks. I don't think there are price earnings ratios of one. Perhaps in the future, I'll look at that too, because I'm very, very intrigued. The last company I bought at a price earnings ratio of one was Cemig, Brazilian utility that was trading at $1 per share 2 years ago, and the earnings were there somewhere in line. Now they are below that, but it was a price earnings ratio of 1-2. Needless to say, the stock price exploded. Now, on cloning investment ideas, if you think that 200 hours of research that I spend on the stock market per month is worth more than $20 for you, for your time. So if your 200 hours are worth more than $20 per month and you like to get research reports, research ideas, investment ideas on stocks, please check my stock market research platform. The link is in the description below on YouTube. So see that there is a 30-day money-back guarantee so that you have really nothing to lose and a lot of time to save, as stock market investing and stock market research really requires a lot of time, a lot of knowledge and a lot of experience, like Pabrai has. Even this, just checking what he is doing, what Einhorn is doing, really takes a lot of time to have a clear idea on what they are doing and whether there are investment opportunities. So to save time, if you want, let me do the research for you. Thank you for watching. Looking forward to your comments. Don't forget to check the Einhorn video and subscribe, because there will be more stock investments from Einhorn, from Pabrai, and from what I find in China. See you in the next video.